What a head.
Willard, love the sound effects. Thanks.
Thank you.
It's hard to believe that David Letterman has been answering viewer mail and presenting the latest in stupid pet tricks for 10 years now on his late night program. To begin our observance of this important milestone, Dave made the trip three flights down to our studio for some coffee and a little chat about his big primetime anniversary show, which airs tomorrow night here on NBC.
It's the David Letterman interview, featuring startling revelations from 10 years of late night, gravity-defying dogs, and some low-cal cooking tips for better health. And now, from Studio 3B in New York's famed GE building, it's Katie and David Letterman.
10 years, a decade of late night with David Letterman. Does it feel like 10 years?
I'll tell you why. In one word, why we've been on the air 10 years. In one word, Johnny Carson. Actually, that's two words. But that would be the reason.
Explain.
Well, as I've pointed out, I think that when we went on the air in February of 1982, we followed The Tonight Show. And it's on, as you know, from 11:30 to 12:30, and then it would be us. And I think, especially in those days, you could put squirrels mating in a cage, and they would get about
you
the
have,
same.
You have, haven't you?
Well, oh, so you've seen the tapes. I think you would get about the same audience. Maybe the demographics would be a bit different, but I think in terms of pure numbers, they would be about the same as we have been able to generate.
Oh, come on.
All right.
Obviously, you're not putting on squirrels mating. You're doing a lot of different kinds of things. What do you look for when you put together a show every night?
We like the show to be, meet the press is really what we're after. If we can do like a 12:30 version of meet the press, then we say to ourselves, yes, yes, another job well done.
We're gonna finish our chicken here. The sauces.
Truffles are expensive, ain't they?
It's very expensive. Costs like $600 a pound.
Wow.
And you know, everybody asks me what they smell like. I always tell them it smells like sex to me. You just try to smell them?
Jeez, what have you been doing?
Actually, in Austria, they pronounce it Schwarzenegger.
Schwarzenegger.
So just to confuse you a little bit.
Yeah. Does the name mean something?
It means black plowman.
Black plowman?
Plowman, yeah. Oh.
Tell me about the wedding and your relationship with the Kennedy family.
What do you want to know?
Well, now, well, how do they feel about having a black plowman in the group?
Hey, I'm going to enjoy a beverage now, if you don't mind.
No problem. In our lovely Today at 40 mug. Did you know it's the Today Show's 40th anniversary?
No, really?
Like I've been in a trunk in a rental car at LaGuardia. No, I had no idea. Oh, and I see it's in color now, too. Wow.
That's right. Isn't this lovely?
No, but see, there you go. Talking about relative terms of success, 10 years seems meager, seems like no accomplishment whatsoever. It seems like a trifle when you compare it to a show that's been on the air long enough to have their own coffee mugs.
That's right. Pretty impressive,
yeah,
huh?
There's a breakthrough.
I understand that you make fun of this revered historic institution known as the Today Show.
Yeah, I've made fun of the show. This is one of my favorite things about being on the air this long, to have this kind of an association. We share crew members, our show and the Today Show, and one of the shared crew members had overheard a conversation where Bryant was supposed to have said, I'm going to go up there and just hit him.
Bryant.
Yeah, yeah. And it was because they had this primetime version of the Today Show, and the producer in those days, who I don't remember his name,
Steve Friedman.
That's right. He came to us and he said, we're going to do this primetime show, and he said, between you and I, it's sort of going to be dull and plodding. So we need some heat. We need something to pep it up. We need to stir up. We need a little controversy. Can you do something? And we said, sure. We'll try and interrupt the show. We'll scream at Bryant with a bullhorn.
See what we can do. Go ahead, Carl. Take a look out there.
Attention. Attention, people of New York City. My name is Lawrence Grossman, the president of NBC News. This primetime program was my idea. And I'm not wearing pants.
Nobody told Bryant. you know, Mr. Friedman, Mr. Big Shot, Mr. Vince McMahon of the World Wrestling Federation didn't mention that to Bryant. So it all comes as a surprise to him. And he was very angry, and I don't blame him. And for years and years and years, he wouldn't speak to me, and he was really, really quite upset.
But now you guys have kissed and made up.
Yeah, see, the thing of it is, I always regretted that because I like him, and I think he's one of a handful of people, and I think NBC is lucky enough to have most of these people who are really good communicators and pure broadcasters. And so I always respected him for that. And so I was never mad at him, but he always wanted to come up and just, you know, do some work on me. And then later we were able, by the way, I could take him. I don't think that was ever in question. Once again, I've forgotten the question.
Yeah, borrow Kleenex.
Oh, sure.
Not the one that you used.
Here.
Yes,
you
thank you.
There.
Thank you.
See,
thank you very much.
See another one pop.
Yeah, I'm
right
sorry.
After.
Yeah, my nose is a little bit runny this morning. I don't know why. You've said when you were a young lad growing up in Indiana, you said all I ever want to be is a talk show host. Is that for real or is that just according to your press release?
I mean, do you think that that's the case?
I
would
hope not.
You're like 11 years old and mom wakes you up in the morning, Dave, what do you want to do when you're 40? Like to be a talk show host, mom.
It's amazing when you think of the people who are coming out with their own talk shows. I mean, Jane Whitney, who's a former NBC Central American correspondent.
I don't know Jane Whitney.
Whoopi Goldberg. Dennis Miller.
Sure.
I mean, we're being inundated with these gabfests. What do you think of all this?
The real reason is they're very cheap to produce.
I was going to say, isn't
very
it because
inexpensive? Very inexpensive to produce. And we do 4 shows a week for under $20. Just to give you a rough idea.
That's
a ballpark figure.
They're very proud of you, aren't they? In fact, you like to poke fun at those pinheads at GE you work for. Do you ever hear from any of them?
The only time I heard from them, and I always thought this was a really telling story, and I enjoyed it when it happened, and it kind of put me in shock for a bit, and it took me a couple of days to kind of ingest this information.
It wasn't a dry skin thing again, was it?
No. We had an anniversary party, and I don't know what year it was. It was, I don't know, 6, 7, I don't know, whatever the year was. And there was a party. And Jack Welch, the Mr. GE, the man who...
The big kahuna.
Yeah, the guy who invented the... He lived next door to Edison or something. Anyway, he comes running up to us at this party, me and my friends at work and so forth. And he's got this big, silly fruit basket, you know. And he comes running up and he shoves it into my arms and he says, keep making fun of us. We love it when you call us pinheads. I just thought, wow, what does this tell you? Here's some insight into the corporate world. And then I saw the other day where their gross revenue for 91 was $63 billion. $63 billion.
With a B.
So I guess if you're turning that kind of cash through a company, you don't care what people call you.
That's right.
Yeah.
So, Bryant, what do you think? You think you could take him or he could take
you? I don't
know.
We're probably in different weight classes.
Maybe. I like when he said NBC is lucky to have you, Bryant. Dave, what a brown noser. Sheesh. Tomorrow morning, Dave will be back to reveal the identity of the guest with the gravity-defying hair and what he thinks of the big to-do about Jay Leno getting the Tonight Show job. Coming up in our second hour, thanks, Willard. David Letterman is back this morning celebrating his big primetime 10th anniversary show tonight on NBC. He's conjured up some fond memories for us and some valuable insight into how this little TV experiment called Late Night with David Letterman has survived for the last 10 years.
It's the David Letterman interview. Featuring exclusive late-night interviewing techniques, personal hygiene of the stars, and some hairdo news you can use. And now, from Studio 3B in New York's famed GE building, it's Katie and David Letterman.
Morning, but all of that seems of little importance once you take a look at the cloud cover photograph made earlier of the United States today.
You started out as a local weatherman. Why did you do that?
What do you mean, why did I do that?
I mean, how did that opportunity present itself?
I was, again, really very lucky. I've been very lucky all my life as far as getting pretty cool jobs. And I was a junior in college, and a friend of mine's brother worked at this television station in Indianapolis. And he said, we're looking for a vacation announcer. Just come on down, and there's going to be like 8 guys that are going to audition, and, you know, audition, and we'll see what happens. Well, not only did I audition, but I got the job, and so part of the duties of the vacation announcer, you would be the weekend weatherman and fill in various positions when folks were on vacation, and that's how I got the job.
Is that when it sort of became apparent that your real future was in comedy?
I'm not sure. I was so excited that, because in those days, it seemed like a miracle that you could be on radio or television. You know, this was like in the late 60s, and television hadn't been as accessible to lay people at that time, I don't think. It seemed like now anybody, so there's so much television, and if you really want to be on television, or even if you don't want to be on television, you can get yourself on.
Get into the fountain.
Get into it?
Come on, get in. If you get fired, I'll get you a job, honest. Just stand in the fountain. Come on over and just stand in there. Put the phone down, for God's sakes. All right, now just get in.
Okay.
Come on.
Yeah! You felt at times that you was living in two worlds.
That's right. You know why? I was raised by poodles. That's the truth. Who are those women out there, by the way?
Neighbors.
I'll get rid of them. Hey. Excuse me.
Both you and Johnny Carson have had some fun with this whole controversy over the Jay Leno thing on The Tonight Show. Is that sort of behind you? A lot of people really do want to know, how ticked off were you when that happened?
I was never angry, really, about that. I was, you know, disappointed, obviously, but I was never angry. And it's interesting to me that somehow the story was that I was angry and that I was mad at The Tonight Show and mad at Carson and mad at Jay and on and on and on. But that aspect of it was so tiny in what was a bigger story. And it was just a matter of having worked for a network for a long time and things usually being great. And then suddenly, within the last year and a half or so, there was some problems, there was some trouble. And the Tonight Show just occupied, it was kind of another item on a list. Well, we had trouble with this, what's the deal there? We had trouble with that, what's the deal there? We had trouble with this. Oh, and then, by the way, now here's The Tonight Show. You guys just kind of drop by and casually mention this to us. So in and of itself, it was nothing that angered me.
Have you since made amends with the network executives here?
Well, I'm not sure I'm in the position to be making the amends.
Well, have they made amends?
Well, I will say that things are better now than they have been. Yeah.
You're going to stick around?
Well, I think I have another year left on my contract. And at that point, it will have been 11 years that we've been here. So we'll just see what things look like then.
Hmm. What about just a couple quick questions?
What do you mean,
questions?
Have I made amends?
Okay, excuse me for living. Have the two parties made amends, okay? You're reading a lot into that question, Dave.
I'm sorry.
All right.
You're very young, aren't you?
Depends. God, I look at myself up there and I look awful.
See, that's what I was talking about earlier.
Now, there are some who say that you are kind of mean-spirited and condescending.
That's crap. I don't know. I've heard this ever since we've gone on the air, and I don't know. I try to be as nice and as hospitable as I can.
Uh-huh.
And if there's going to be some sort of incendiary display, I'll usually wait for the other person to start. You know, I don't really. It's no. There's nothing premeditated about this. There's no malice involved here. We're not looking to be mean or hurtful or to get laugh.
You don't think you're funny at other people's expense sometimes?
Well, I didn't say that. Maybe we are funny at somebody else's expense, but I'm not sure that that's meanness. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, you've been on the show. Was I mean to you?
No.
Do you know somebody I was specifically mean to?
No, but I remember when Natasha Kinski was on, and she had that hairdo that
right.
defied gravity.
Right.
You wouldn't talk about anything but
no,
her hairdo.
See, not true. We talked about many other things, and then she finally noticed her hair in the monitor, and she said, oh, I look like hell. And I just said, well, see, that's what I was trying to say. If somebody has, you know, like a grouper in her hair, and you don't... and you make a joke about it. And actually, I didn't really make a joke about it. I just said, you know.
What's that grouper in your hair?
No. Your hair looks odd today. And she just said, well, you know, like I was too sophisticated to understand that it was cute to have a, you know.
Or avant-garde or something.
Yeah, yeah. But, you know, but if that's mean, I guess, you know, it's all in the perception.
Now, one guest has been on 62 times.
Oh, Lord. I did my research.
Marv Albert.
Oh, Marv Albert.
Now, he's a nice guy.
A guy.
He's
with
got a great
grouper in his hair.
Why have you had Marv on so many times?
He's just great. He's entertaining. He's very likable. He brings on those wacky sports bloopers that we can't seem to get enough of those. And so that's why we have Marv on. And also, did I mention he's in the building?
Can you see doing this another 10 years?
I don't think so. I'm very surprised that we're here for 10 years. You know, on one hand, 10 years seems like, well, that's kind of an accomplishment. And then on the other hand, when you look at the Today Show or the Tonight Show, 30 years and 40 years, it doesn't really seem like we're even getting our feet wet yet.
Don't forget, Dave's late night anniversary show airs tonight at 9:30 on NBC. And Dave, I hope you're watching this morning because we have more of those zany sports stories coming up next. Not Marv Albert, this time Lynn Berman. But first, these messages.